Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the band pass and the band stop filter. So in the last couple of videos, we had seen that how to design the active as well as the passive low pass and the high pass filter using the resistor and the capacitor. And we had seen that this low pass filter passes the low frequency components from the input signal, while the high pass filter passes the high frequency components from the input signal. But sometimes in some applications, we are only interested in the particular band of frequencies. So for such applications, we can use this bandpass filter. So as you can see, this bandpass filter passes only certain band of frequencies and it rejects all the frequencies which is outside of this band. So now there are many ways in which we can design this bandpass filter. And one of the way is to design this bandpass filter using the series RLC circuit, and particularly when you take the output across this resistor, then the response of this circuit will be very similar to the response of this bandpass filter. And we have already seen this in the earlier videos of a series resonance in the RLC circuit. So for more information, you can check that video. But in this video, we will learn how to design this bandpass filter just by using this high pass and the low pass filter. So just by cascading this high pass filter and the low pass filter, we can design this bandpass filter. So now let us understand how this combination will act as a bandpass filter. So let us say we have one low pass filter which is having a cutoff frequency, let's say fc1, and let us say we have one high pass filter which is having a cutoff frequency of fc2. Now whenever we cascade this high pass and the low pass filter, then we will get an overlapping region between the individual responses of this high pass and the low pass filter. And this overlapping region will act as a bandpass filter. So in this way, just by cascading this high pass and the low pass filter, we can design this bandpass filter. So now if you see the frequency response of this bandpass filter, you will immediately notice that this filter will have a two cutoff frequencies. The one is known as the lower cutoff frequency and the other frequency is known as the higher cutoff frequency. And beyond this cutoff frequencies, the roll-off will be at the rate of 20 dB per decade, and that is particularly true when you design this bandpass filter just by cascading the first order high pass and the low pass filter. Now the frequency difference between this cutoff frequency is known as the bandwidth of this bandpass filter. So now let us see some of the parameters which defines this bandpass filter. So as I said earlier, the difference between the two cutoff frequencies is known as the bandwidth of this filter, and the geometric mean of these two cutoff frequencies is known as the center frequency of this bandpass filter. So for this frequency response, the center frequency will be somewhere around here. So that will be the center frequency of this bandpass filter. And if we see the phase response of this bandpass filter, then the phase response will look like this. So as you can see, at zero frequency, the output will lead the input by a 90 degree. And as we move towards the center frequency, the phase difference will gradually reduce. So now when we start moving away from this center frequency, then the output will start lagging the input signal. And at f is equal to infinity, the output will lag the input by a 90 degree. Alright, so now as we have seen the phase and the frequency response of this bandpass filter, so let us take one example based on this bandpass filter. So in this example, we have given this filter and we have been asked to find the bandwidth of this given filter. So as you can see in this example, the high pass filter and the low pass filter are cascaded, and using this cascade connection, the bandpass filter has been designed. So to find the bandwidth of this filter, first of all, let us find the cutoff frequency of this individual high pass and the low pass filter. So let us first of all find the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter. And let us assume that the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter is fc1 and the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter is fc2. Now we know that the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter can be given by the equation 1 divided by 2 pi into RC. So now, if we put the value of this resistor and capacitor, then we will find the cutoff frequency fc for this high pass filter will be around 10.61 kHz. So in this way, we have found this cutoff frequency of this high pass filter as 10.61 kHz. So similarly, Now let us find the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter. So again, the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter can be given by the equation 1 divided by 2 pi into RC. And if we put the value of this resistor and capacitor, then the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter will be 106.1 kilohertz. So in this way, we have found the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter as 106.1 kilohertz. So now the bandwidth of this band pass filter can be defined as the difference between these two cutoff frequencies. So the bandwidth of this band pass filter will be fc2 minus fc1, that is equal to 106.1 minus 10.61 kilohertz, and that is nothing but 95.5 kilohertz. So roughly we can say that this band pass filter having a bandwidth of 100 kilohertz. So in this example, now if you see here, we have designed this band pass filter just by cascading this passive high pass and the low pass filter. And as this filter is designed using these passive components, so the actual values of this cutoff frequencies will be slightly different from the design values. And the reason is that the input impedance of this high pass filter will affect the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter, and vice versa, the impedance of this low pass filter will also affect the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter. So in this way, because of this cascade connection of these passive filters, the design frequencies and the actual cutoff frequencies will be slightly different. And to avoid that, we can isolate the two stages by using the buffer. So in the last video, we have already seen that by using this op-amp as a buffer, we can isolate the different stages of this filter. So instead of using this passive low pass and the high pass filter, we can use this active low pass and the high pass filter. And just by cascading these two, active low pass and the high pass filter, we can design this band pass filter. And by using this op-amp as a buffer, we can isolate the two different stages as well. And suppose if we want the gain from this active filter, then we can configure this op-amp either in an inverting or a non-inverting configuration. So in this way, not only we can isolate the two different stages, but we can also achieve the gain out of this filter. So now, like we have seen this bandpass filter, let us see one more filter whose response is exactly opposite to that of this bandpass filter. So this filter is known as the band stop filter or a band reject filter. So this band stop or a band reject filter rejects certain band of frequencies and it passes all other frequencies which is out of this particular band. And if we see the frequency response of this band stop filter, it will look like this. So like as you can see here, this band stop filter rejects a particular band of frequencies and it passes all the frequencies which is beyond this particular band. So now in the earlier video of a resonance in the parallel RLC circuit, we have already seen that by connecting this resistor, capacitor and inductor in a parallel, we can design this band stop filter. And particularly when we take the output across this resistor, then the response of this parallel RLC circuit will be very similar to the response of this band stop filter. So for more information, you can check that video on a resonance in the parallel RLC circuit. But in this video, we will see that how we can design this band stop filter by using this low pass and the high pass filter. So before we see that, first of all, let us carefully see once again the response of this band stop filter. So now if you see the response, particularly this portion, this is nothing but the response of the low pass filter. And if you see this portion of the response, that is nothing but the response of a high pass filter. So in this way, just by adding the responses of this low pass filter and the high pass filter, we can design this band stop filter. So now what we can do, we can provide the same input to this both low pass as well as the high pass filter. And just by adding their individual responses, we can get this response of a band stop filter. And we can easily achieve this response by using this op-amp circuit. So as you can see here, this portion is nothing but the high pass filter and the lower portion is nothing but the low pass filter. So as you can see here, we have given the same input to this low pass as well as the high pass filter. And just by adding their individual responses by summer circuit, we can design this band stop filter. So now to get more idea about this band stop filter, let us take one example. So in this example, we have been given the design of this active band stop filter. And in this example, we have been asked to find the stop band of this band stop filter. So the stop band is nothing but the frequency band which is being rejected by this band stop filter. And to find that, first of all, let us find the cutoff frequency of these individual filters. Let us say the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter is, let's say, fc1, and the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter is, let's say, fc2. And as we know, the cutoff frequency for this high pass filter can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi into rc. And if we put all the values of this resistor and capacitor, then the value of this cutoff frequency will be 1.59 kilohertz. Similarly, now let us find the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter. So the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi into rc. And if you put all the values of this resistor and capacitor, then we will get this cutoff frequency as 994 hertz. So in this way, we have found the cutoff frequency of this high pass filter as 1.59 kilohertz, and the cutoff frequency of this low pass filter as 994 hertz. So the stop band can be given by fc2 minus fc1, that is 1590 hertz minus 994 hertz, that is nothing but 596 hertz. So we can say that this band stop filter rejects the band of frequencies starting from roughly around 1 kilohertz and up to 1.6 kilohertz. So this filter rejects around 600 hertz of frequencies between these two cutoff frequencies, and it passes all the frequencies which is beyond these cutoff frequencies. So now, so far, this band pass and the band stop filters which we have discussed are the second order filters, because if you see the transfer function of these two filters, they will have a two number of poles in the denominator. And in another way, if you see, these two filters had a two number of reactive components in their circuitry. So in that sense also, we can say that these two filters were the second order filters. So now, if you want the sharp cutoff, then we can go for the higher order filters. So I hope in this video you understood about this band pass as well as the band stop filter. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.